Need it fixed? Service with a Smile repairs electronics. On the phone at 836-0454. On the web at servicewithasmile.com.
Hi, you've clicked on the Weather Extreme video. I'm ABC 3340 meteorologist Brian Peters coming to you from Mount Cheeha. And it's been an active night. Let's get right to the maps this morning. Across the southeastern U.S., we have a bit of a stationary front that is the focus of development that is going on right now. At 500 millibars, it's a rather flat pattern, but with that flatness, we also have a number of different waves that are occurring, and one of those disturbances is coming through the Tennessee River Valley this morning. Temperatures across the U.S. are relatively mild as we look at the overall U.S. Map, and especially across the southeastern U.S. where we're in the 50s and 60s. A little closer to home, you can see that across the Tennessee River Valley, it's generally in the mid and upper 50s, but across central Alabama, it's in the lower 60s this morning. Certainly rather mild for a March morning. And here's a look at the QPF forecast. Some of that is today, and some of that will come on day four. That's about Tuesday time frame. Here is the severe weather outlook for day one from the SPC, the Storm Prediction Center. Moderate risk over a large part of Georgia and South Carolina. Slight risk extending all the way back to about Tupelo and across the northern third of Alabama. And of course, we do have two areas of echoes we see on radar. One is the one that came through last night. It's already in South Carolina. It's outrunning the weather system. And then behind that is a second one in northwest Alabama. And that one is already responsible for a severe thunderstorm watch that covers a good portion of the northern third of Alabama, and some severe thunderstorm warnings that have been issued already this morning. So a very active pattern in store today. I think when that weather gets by, we'll be out of the woods. But day four, Storm Prediction Center still has us outlooked as the pattern remains very, very active. Here's a real quick look at yesterday, and this is a look at some of the severe storm reports across the area, and of course, a good deal of hail and damaging wind. It looks like one tornado reported there in North Georgia. All right, let's take a quick look. Here is the 500 millibar pattern for today at midday, and there's that shortwave trough coming through the middle Mississippi River Valley that is responsible for our weather now. And of course, we have a bit of a surface low moving along that front. That surface low should move rather quickly and get out of here and should be off the Atlantic coast by this time or by midday on Sunday. So good riddance to that. I mean, we need the rain, but we don't need the severe weather. And on Sunday, it looks like high pressure. Looks like the possibility of a high in that position, we could end up with a bit of a wedge. We'll have to watch for that on Monday and watch for the possibility of some cooler air. But it looks like we'll stay dry as the next system begins to develop. And here is the next system on Tuesday at midday, 500 millibars. And this is coming out of West Texas and the Big Bend country. And that will be helping to induce or produce a surface low over Texas that will be coming our way. And that moves our way Tuesday and into Wednesday. By Wednesday, it is up over the eastern Great Lakes, and the weather is beginning to diminish across here. So it does look like the latter part of Tuesday and into early Wednesday is our next shot at some significant precipitation. The weather clears out by Thursday, and we're in good shape. And Friday, you can see we're back under a bit of a zonal flow with that major closed low up over New England and just off the New England coast. And at the surface, a rather benign pattern for the southeastern U.S. Now, let's real quick, we'll go out into the future just a little bit. This is Sunday the 23rd, 500 millibars showing another shortwave trough moving through the flow that will be bringing us another shot at some precipitation. Wednesday the 26th, once again, another very, very big closed low. That is another potent system with the potential for some severe weather. But remember, this is voodoo land, so we can't tell for sure. And then finally, out on the 30th, almost the end of March, and another system on the West Coast. So basically, the bottom line is the GFS is suggesting that everything is going to remain rather active. Well, I appreciate you tuning in to the Weather Extreme video. I'm at Mount Cheeha speaking to a group of the Alabama Hiking Trail Society talking about hiking and weather. Certainly hope that you have a great Saturday. By all means, stay alert to the weather and stay weather safe. Hope you have a great weekend, and God bless.